got enemy fighters in sight. They're all armed, maneuvering on your position. We'll be setting up for an engagement.
After a week of looting, executions, and forcing residents...
These people fear imminent attack.
Hundreds of refugees are streaming into Turkey to escape the increasing violence in Syria.
Everywhere we can see signs of recent battle.
We've now been through nearly a decade of war.
How many hundreds of thousands have been slaughtered? When will it stop?
You can see what a rural country it is.
Yes.
And most of the people who died were killed with machetes.
Approximately 5 to 8 minutes of an intense airstrike.
Also, two media centers.
Whoa.
Tragedy unfolding in the Central African nation of Rwanda keeps getting worse. There is strong evidence that both sides in the vicious civil war are preparing new massacres of civilians.
In just the last 24 hours, more than 250,000 people have fled Rwanda and its terror. Every day, an already horrendous situation somehow gets worse.
So tonight, I am announcing that the American combat mission in Iraq has ended.
For American soldiers returning from the wars abroad, the issue of veterans unable to transition back to civilian life has become a growing problem.
In the humanitarian demining environment, the State Department estimates that there are between 60 and 100 million landmines buried throughout the world.
The most victims are children. It is about 64 to 65% of the landmine victims are children.
They persevered because of a belief that out of the ashes of war, a new beginning could be born in this cradle of civilization. Now, it's time to turn the page.
People are realizing how important it is that survivors share their stories, and share their stories especially with young people.
It is clear to all of us that hate, racism, anti-Semitism, and the ideology of genocide in our world is a reality that we cannot afford to ignore.
I think for a lot of us coming back, we're young men and women, we're active, we want to remain active after our injuries and going through such traumatic instances. And these organizations, they really bring people, they show you what you're still capable of. In an instant, their lives have been forever changed, and you wonder what your life will be like, and to surround themselves with people that love and care about them, and that to keep a positive attitude, and that it does get better.
Mine victims who overcome their injuries have a great family support. In my work, we're working with peer support with other victims. Crawled out of the vehicle. I was bleeding. I just thought it's been a great life. And then I decided if I was going to live, I just want to marry my girlfriend and be a teacher and be a father. And that was it.
It's not often you get to report good news in times of conflict.
The mood is cheerful. Soldiers are smiling and relieved.
You know, I think people are becoming more aware that what happens around the world ultimately have consequences for us.
Our time of service to our newest veterans has only just begun.
There are survivors all around the world that we're connecting with.
Billions of young people want to move beyond the shackles of poverty and conflict.
بس سوريا ترجع النظام مثل أولي ونمشي نمزح ونضحك مثل أول. ما أريد ألهش ذا. ناكل تراب بس سوريا ترجع. بس.